I'm in front of the disposal facility.
Excellent. Excellent.
How's that sneaking suit working out?
I'm nice and dry, but it's a little hard to move.
Bear with it. It's designed to prevent hypothermia. This is Alaska.
A surveillance camera.
Hangar door is open. A little bit, at least. You can get in that way if you want.
Snake, this is McDonald Miller. Campbell told me about the situation here. I thought I might be of some use.
There's no one I'd rather have in a foxhole than you.
Well, I know lots about survival.
Run, Snake! Aim for the legs. Knock the gecko over, then aim for the neck.
I don't see any enemies around here. Okay, we'll go through the door all the way at the back.
Otacon, last time around, we had a few complications and wound up going through the commander's office in the basement.
That's right. I remember now. But there's no need to go all the way down there this time, right? The back door takes us straight where we need to go.
Good point.
Okay, then. Let's get to the back door. The panel lights are dead, too. Looks like the power's out. Still, there's no need to take the elevator, is there? Hurry up and head to the gate at the north end of the building. Huh? Snake, that door is locked.
How do I open it?
Security is shut down altogether. You can't release the lock without activating it. You'll have to log in somewhere. I've got it, Snake. My old office is close by. With the power on, you should be able to unlock the door from there. And if you check the facility records, we can find out Rex's status and who's been in and out. You remember where it is, Snake?
I'm not senile yet.
Just to be safe, I'm marking it on your map. You old geezer. Snake, the password is 48273. Think you can remember that?
I told you, I'm not senile. Yet.
Snake, I've checked the APU on this floor and engaged the generator. Energy output is low, but it should be enough to power the elevator. Try the elevator and see if it's working. Okay, first go down the central hallway. Don't worry, it's not electrified anymore. Everything looks exactly like I remember it. Except for that wall way in back, anyway. I still can't believe how much damage you caused in such a small space.
The switchboard. Nailed it with a remote control missile to shut down the electric current in the floor. The guidance system and those things takes up so much space, it hardly leaves any room for explosives.
Didn't make much of a bang, huh?
Hardly. Switchboard's still intact.
You're right. The wiring past the switch circuits could still be live.
Wait a minute. I'm not gonna get shocked if I walk on this floor, am I?
No need to worry. As long as you don't turn the current back on.
Thank you. Hold on. I want to check security. It's a 5-digit number. Nice job. At least your memory hasn't gone bad. Conjuring up any unpleasant memories, is it? I was being attacked by Frank Yeager.
Yeah, I remember.
If you hadn't shown up when you did, gives me the shivers just thinking about it. Snake, you saved my life.
Frank's body. But it was me that crippled him in the first place. She must have hated me too.
We shouldn't have been so trusting. I blame myself too. I helped develop Rex. That's why it was so easy for me to believe her feelings were genuine. But she was only using us to atone for her sins.
So what? What did she do to us?
You forgot already? She betrayed you. She stole your blood.
If that was all, it should have been over and done with in South America. Why'd she join us afterward?
Well,
she has us come rescue her, and then she turns around and goes straight back to Liquid. Why would she do that?
I don't know, Snake. But it looks like she's still with him.
What?
I just had a look at the security access logs. As I thought, there's people coming and going at frequent intervals. In fact, the records show some recent activity. Look at this. It's an image taken a few hours ago by a surveillance camera up ahead.
Naomi.
And Vamp.
The Beauty and the Beast.
They've been through here. And from what we've gleaned from the security records, it can only mean one thing. They're headed for Rex's old underground hangar. I finished rebooting security and released the locks. The door on the first floor ought to open for you now.
Amazing. Almost makes me nostalgic for the days when you needed a key card for every door.
Yep. It's been 9 years. All you really have to do is reinterpret the old technology in terms of the new. Getting old isn't all that bad, you know. Let's get going, Snake.
I finished unlocking the door on the first floor. It should open now.
I've been waiting for you, Snake.
Who are you?
Neither enemy nor friend.
Gray Fox. Colonel, that ninja is Gray Fox.
Ridiculous. You yourself in Zanzibar land.
Gecko! We've got Gecko! Hallway leading to the elevator. You'll have to do something before you can get to the first floor. Take the stairs down and go to the north door. I'll open it for you with the Mark III. Gecko, The Mark III is totally defenseless while working on the door. You'll have to distract the Gecko so they don't spot it.
Thank you.
Forget it, Snake. It's locked. There's no place to run. Stand your ground. It's your only option.
Yo, Snake. I finished laundering that rail gun you picked up just now. Knock yourself out. It's on the house.
Thanks.
Time for another bedtime story, Snake. This one's about crying wolf. You don't need me to tell you there's whole nations in Africa tearing themselves apart in the name of ethnic cleansing. Well, she was born into that environment. When she was a little girl, her village was attacked by rival armed factions. Her parents and siblings were slaughtered, and she was left a refugee. She took her last surviving relative, her baby brother, and ran as far as she could away from the war zone. One day, they came across an enemy unit, so she took her brother and hid in an abandoned shack. And then her brother started to cry. She knew that if the soldiers heard the noise, they would find them and kill them both. So she wrapped her hand as tight as she could around his mouth. As the footsteps gradually went away, she came back to her senses. Her brother wasn't crying anymore. Horrified, she pulled her hand away, covered in sweat and spit. He wasn't breathing. They say wolves eat their own pups when they die. She was spotted wandering through the thick of battle, carrying her dead brother in her arms. She had visions, too. A wolf walking alongside her. Every night, the wolf would howl and cry, just like her brother did that day. Eventually, she made it to a government-run refugee camp. But by then, her brother's body had rotted away. The camp was crowded with refugees like herself, and little children like her brother. Day and night, she was tormented by the cries of babies. The wolf that followed her heard her sorrowful screams and answered. He made his way around the camp, and one by one, he silenced the children. She tried to stop it, but she was powerless to stop the wolf. A few days passed, and on the eve of the enemy's raid, there wasn't a child left. The adults who survived were torn up pretty bad. Of course, there was never any wolf in that camp. She was the one who killed those babies. But she couldn't bring herself to admit it. She couldn't bear the thought of herself going from one baby to the next, howling like a wolf, snuffing out their little lives. And she never did, even as Crying Wolf, a lonely beast forever stalking the battlefield. Snake, fighting with you made Wolf finally accept what she'd done. She was cleansed by you. If the cries she heard of children on the battlefield have been silenced, it's because of you. You ought to be proud. Three down, one to go. All that's left is Mantis. But you should know, Snake, she's been controlling all the other beasts. She's the beast of beasts. Don't let her get her hooks in you.
I won't.
See you around, Snake.
Welcome home, Wolf.
Thank you.
Hold it, Snake. Time to change the disc. I know, it's a pain. But you need to swap disc 1 for disc 2. You see the disc labeled 2?
No.
Huh? Oh, wait. We're on PlayStation 3. It's a Blu-ray disc. Dual layered, too. No need to swap.
Damn it, Otacon. Get a grip.
Yeah, what an age we live in, huh, Snake? Wonder what they'll think of next.